हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू अचीव आईएएस। माय नेम इज़ आयुष मेठी। हियर इज़ योर इंग्लिश पॉडकास्ट अबाउट द डिस्प्यूट बिटवीन चाइना एंड भूटान। लेट अस स्टार्ट द लेक्चर। फॉर द थर्ड टाइम चाइना हैज़ रिपीटेड इट्स टेरिटोरियल क्लेम इन द ईस्टर्न सेक्टर ऑफ भूटान। हियर इज़ ताशिगेंग डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड यू कैन सी द सत्किंग वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी which has been in news recently because of this dispute. Now, what is the territorial claim of China? Actually, China made the claim during the online meeting of 58th Global Environment Facility Council, GEF Council. It tried to obstruct the funding project to develop the Satkeng Wildlife Sanctuary in eastern Bhutan. However, GEF Council cleared the funding to the project after Bhutan protested against the Chinese claims. First of all, let us talk about what is GEF, Global Environment Facility Council. Actually, it is a US-based global body to finance projects in the environment sector. So, as I told you, the funding has been cleared, but still, now the world will recognize it as a disputed area, and that is a strategy of China. First, make a claim on a sovereign area, make it appear as a disputed area, and then world will recognize as a disputed area, making the China's claim more stronger. China claims that boundary between China and Bhutan has never been delimited. It has also disputed areas over eastern, central and western sectors of Bhutan. For example, we have Doklam Plateau. And you all know about the issue of Doklam. But the claim by China on the eastern sector of Bhutan was very surprising, because China has not objected earlier to the funding provided to the sanctuary. There you can see the Satkeng Wildlife Sanctuary. The claim is very new. And the Tashigang area, here is the Tashigang area, where the Satkeng Wildlife Sanctuary is located, does not share a boundary with China. It shares the boundary with India, India's Arunachal Pradesh. That's also a very surprising point. Now, what is the Bhutan's position? Bhutan, as all have estimated, that it totally rejected the claim made by China. Bhutan said that Satkeng Wildlife Sanctuary is an integral and sovereign territory of Bhutan. Also, Satkeng Sanctuary in the past too has received such grants, including in 2018 and 2019. Bhutan has conveyed its views and position to China through the embassy in New Delhi. Because, and that is very important for your prelims also, note it down, Bhutan and China don't have embassies in each other's countries. They don't have any formal diplomatic relations as well. The countries conduct their diplomatic communications through Delhi. China and Bhutan have a dispute in only two sectors of border, one in northern and second in west Doklam. Here I showed you the Doklam Plateau. Now, concerns for India. What are the concerns for India? China's new territorial claim is a part of larger Chinese tactics. It wants to put pressure on China's small neighbors so that they will not go closer to India. China wants to punish its small neighbors. For example, in 2017, China intruded into Doklam Plateau. Doklam Plateau is claimed by Bhutan, and there was a large standoff between India and Chinese army, as you can remember. So this is a part of great strategy of China. First put the pressure on India's friend and prevent it becoming a close friend of India. China might be doing this to put the pressure on India as well, so that it can divert, India can divert attention from its aggression in Ladakh. And the, here's the third point, which is very important, and you should always remember it, that Satkeng is situated in the border with Arunachal Pradesh, and some part of Arunachal Pradesh is also claimed by China. So by claiming Bhutan's eastern boundary, China is attempting to double down on its claims over Arunachal Pradesh as well, because here on Arunachal Pradesh, China do not have any control. So it want to directly control over it. Now let us talk about Indo-Bhutan Treaty of Peace and Friendship 1949. It was revised and negotiated in 2007. Earlier, the treaty of 1949 provided for perpetual peace, friendship, free trade and commerce, and equal justice to each other's citizens. And very important point was, Bhutan allowed India to guide its foreign policy and defense affairs. As I told you, the treaty was renegotiated in 2007, and there was a provision that gradually India will abolish the need to take India's, abolish the need of Bhutan to take India's guidance or foreign policy. In other words, India will try to cut the dependence of Bhutan on India. In other words, it will encourage Bhutan sovereignty. But still, even after the treaty of 2007, which had the provision of abolishing the provision of India's guidance on the foreign policy of Bhutan, still we are virtually responsible for protecting Bhutan from any kind of external threat that Chinese military poses. The new treaty also says Bhutan can import arms as long as Indian interests are not harmed and there is no re-export of weapons either by government or individuals. So still we are responsible for protecting Bhutan's border from China. Now, as I told you, we are responsible, but what is the way forward? What is the solution for us? See, Bhutan has protested against Chinese territorial claims in the eastern Bhutan and in the western Bhutan as well. And it said that it will also contest in future if China refers to territory as disputed. India and Bhutan now need to work together on this issue, because safety of border from China is a concern for both India and Bhutan. Recently, we have also decided to build the road, which is called Guwahati Trashigang Tawang Link. Here's the Guwahati, here's Trashigang, and here's Tawang. We will connect those three by building a road. You can see here. It will give us more strategic spaces where we can fastly deploy our military in Bhutan to counter China. So here was your video. Thanks for watching. Jai Hind. God bless you all.